The message board in Basecamp is the perfect place to make announcements, pitch an idea, pose a question, or share progress. And in many cases, it can replace email. I'm Kimberly from Basecamp's customer success team, and in this video, I'm gonna do a deep dive into the message board and show you all its features and how it can help you stay organized. To get started, select the message board tool from your project homepage, which will open up a new message. If there are already messages on the message board, you'll hit the green New Message button at the top left. You'll give your message a title, then write your message just below it. There are lots of formatting options here, including bolding and italicizing, changing the color of your text, adding highlighting, and even increasing the font size to create headers. You can also hyperlink text to an outside website, and when you link to content from sites like YouTube, Spotify, and Twitter, Basecamp will give you the option to embed that media so that it displays directly within the message. When you paste in a URL from another part of Basecamp, the link adjusts automatically to identify where in Basecamp it came from. You can add attachments to your message with the paperclip icon or by dragging the image or file directly onto the message. You can rearrange your attachments by dragging and dropping. And if you'd like to split up a gallery of images, you can move your cursor between images and add a hard return to bump them to a separate line. This will also make images appear larger within the message. If you need to delete an attachment from your draft, just click on the image or file, then hit the trash can icon. Above the message title, you'll see an area where you can give your message a category. We've given you a few standard options, but you can create your own by selecting Edit Categories. Changing the category here will only affect the message board within this project. But if you're an account owner or an admin, you can change the message categories across the entire account. To do that, you'll go to Admin Land just below your avatar and select Change Message Categories. Once you're ready to post your message, you can select who should receive a notification in their Hey menu. You can select just the people who are actively involved on the project, everyone who has access to the project at all, or you can pick and choose people from the list. Now, keep in mind that regardless of who gets a notification, anyone who has access to the project will be able to view your message. The message will only be hidden if you have clients on the project and you've chosen not to share the message with them. I made a separate video all about working with clients, so I'll link to that in the YouTube description for this video. At the bottom, you'll see three options. You can save your message as a draft so you can continue to edit it and post it later. You can post the message immediately, or you can schedule your message to send automatically at a future date and time. This is perfect for those night owls who want to work late into the evening, but post their message at a normal hour. When you save a message as a draft, or you schedule it to send later, you'll find those drafts and scheduled messages in two places. When you open up the message board again, you'll see a link at the top reminding you that you have drafts, scheduled messages, or both. Clicking on the link will get you to those messages and you can continue editing the message or post it immediately. You can also find drafts and scheduled messages in your navigation bar under My Stuff and then My Drafts, where you'll find all drafted and scheduled messages. Scheduled messages are indicated with a blue bar along with a date and time they are scheduled to post. When your message is posted, you'll see the category along with its coordinating emoji at the top of the message if a category has been assigned. You'll also see this emoji and category combination from the message board list view. You can filter messages by category with a drop-down menu at the top right. Now, by default, the most recent posts appear at the top of your message board, but sometimes you might have a message that's more important than the rest, like a welcome message for new people added to a project, or instructions for how you'd like everyone on the account to use each of the Basecamp tools. To highlight a message, you can pin it to the top of your message board. With a message open, use the three-dot menu at the top right and select Pin. That will keep that message at the top of the message board. You can pin multiple messages and they'll appear separated from the rest of the message board posts. You can unpin a message with the same three-dot menu at the top. In addition to pinning messages, you also have some other options for how messages appear on the message board. Using the three-dot menu at the top of the message list view, you can change how messages are sorted. You could sort the list alphabetically, which works great when you want to use the message board like a table of contents. Or you could sort the messages by most recent comments, which puts the message with the most recent discussion at the top. One thing to note is that when you change the order for how messages are sorted, it changes the order for how it appears for everyone on the project, not just you. Now, just like Basecamp to-dos and Basecamp documents and files, any comments on the message board stay with the message. So you're not having to go back and forth between emails, Slack messages, text messages, or any other form of communication to keep track of the latest updates. Everything's organized, as it should be. So that's the message board. Now, if you're ever not sure when you should use the message board instead of one of the other Basecamp communication tools like the Campfire or Pings, not to worry. I made a video all about it. I break down the three different tools and when it's best to use each one. I'll link to it in the YouTube description. And as always, if you have any questions, please reach out. That question mark in the bottom right corner of your screen will get you to our Basecamp help guides and also link to reach our team directly.